doesn't make me wrong, because at 16 I seen through Obama's smoke screen. Like, when I was 16, my mother and father, basically my mom, wanted to go vote. And I was telling her that it was a hoax, like, don't do it. And Obama's a fraud. And Obama is not going to do what he says. Like, it's just smoke and mirrors. And I don't know what was going on at that time when I was 16, but it's just something about that election that I just couldn't do. I couldn't believe it. He's biracial, that's one. He's a white man, that's one. Because anything your mother is genetically, that's what you are. That's basically what you're made of. And I never voted, and I never plan on voting, because it's just propaganda. So to make a long story short, I'm thinking about Kamala Harris, and I'm so proud that people are waking up to her. And this is like crazy, because I seen the picture of her pouring hot sauce on chicken, and it's makes me so happy to see people are waking up to her. And a lot of elders are calling her out, and a lot of young youth are waking up to her. I like YouTube now because I don't feel alone. And I know if it's more than one person, then I don't feel alone. And I like the fact that a lot of people are calling her out. I mean, it's an assault to my intelligence, because I don't eat chicken and hot sauce like that. So just in 2019, just to see that picture of her bringing out the hot sauce, why wouldn't you bring up a certain, why wouldn't you bring up certain issues? You want to bring out hot sauce and chicken like that? It's just so old. That stereotype is so old. And it needs to stop, because it's making her look ignorant. It's making her look like a fool. When will it stop? You know, I'm 26 years old, but when will it stop? I never spoke about Gucci. With the sweater of blackface, the black sweater and the red lips. I never spoke about this. But when will it stop? Even Katy Perry wearing blackface shoes, when will it stop? Why is it that my great-grandmother is gone and this is still going on? It's getting tiring now. You know, I know that white people feed off of fear. I know that certain entities feed off of fear and depression and lower vibrations, and why they are trying to inflict this on us for fear. It's just terrible. Lower entities feed off of fear. Lower entities feed off of sadness. So if a person sees that, they want to get riled up or sad or think this is what we are. We are what is projected in media when it's not. You know, I don't buy Gucci. I don't buy anything that disrespect me, or I don't go into any store that disrespects me, or if I find out about it, I don't support any store that disrespect me. I even stopped buying I even stopped giving my money to Asians as far as eyebrows and all these artificial things. I cut 95% of the artificial stuff out. People want to talk about I wear wigs or weaves on YouTube, but I wear my natural hair in public. I wear my afro. I dye my hair. I moisturize my hair. I take care of my hair. And I even stopped giving Asians my money. I do my own eyebrows. I bought my own systems. I never was into getting my nails done, acrylics, and all that stuff when I was younger. You never could catch me in a nail salon. You could never catch me getting acrylics. I never believed in nails. I never believed in acrylics and all that artificial stuff because that holds bacteria. And they won't tell you that. I was never into the artificial thing. And as I reach my mid-20s, it's nothing like being in your essence. If a guy can't appreciate you in your essence or natural state, then maybe you need to leave him alone. If a guy can't love you for your natural self, then you need to leave him alone. You know, all these additives are not you. And I believe a lot of these female YouTubers on YouTube, I believe a lot of them, all these additives are not you. And I also think about spirituality also comes to mind as far as Gucci and all these artificial things are not you. You're losing yourself being someone else. So I also thought about what my father told me when I was younger, a teenager. You losing yourself being someone else. You're losing your true essence being someone else. I feel so bad for the younger generation and these babies coming up in the social media mess. You know, if a guy can't get what he wants from you, he'll block you. If a guy can't get what he wants from you, he'll hurt you. These are crazy times we're living in. The best thing you can do is love yourself, appreciate yourself, and don't change yourself for any human being. Stay true to your essence, stay true to your spirit, stay true to your mind and body, and love yourself. I am 100% authentic with my videos. So, you know, whoever's listening, I want them to hear something authentic. You know, they have a lot of people that do body language or voice recognition through YouTube, and it's just how I feel. I want to look at this video a few years from now or say that, wow, 17 to 26, I was true to myself. I hope that people use YouTube as a tool to build and take information that's important to you. Download some videos that inspire you. Download some videos. Take notes. You could take a lot of notes from YouTube. And learn. But yeah, I love YouTube. Because I don't feel alone. Even about politics. There's people that are asleep. And there's people that knows what's going on. It benefits you to know what's going on because it can help you in life. It benefits you when you study because someone can tell you some bullshit and you already know the truth. It saves you ahead of time. So peace out, guys. I hope everyone have a safe and blessed Sunday.